Hi everybody, this is Jennifer with Choice Slides, and in this tutorial I'm going to show you how easy it is to add a frame to your images and then animate them. In this case, I'm going to use a PNG frame, and honestly you can find these all over the internet. You do want to make sure that the inside of your frame is transparent. So I have selected this image, and you can see over here this little checkerboard in the middle. That indicates that the inside of the frame is transparent. So you're looking for PNGs. JPEG will be solid in the middle. So I'm going to drag and drop this into a slide. Then I need to find an image to go with it. And I'll just use this one. I'm going to drag and drop it right underneath the frame in my layers list, but above the word background, and I'll just let go right there. So now in my preview window, I just need to size and make sure that my image looks good under the frame. And it doesn't matter that this is huge, by the way. So I'm just going to use my mouse wheel and just kind of reduce my photo a little bit. So this isn't the size I want. This isn't where I want, but that's okay. So I have my frame and I have my picture underneath my frame. So in my layers list, I'm going to select both layers, and you do this by holding down your shift key. Then I'm going to click on the add group icon, and this will put both of them into a group. Now I'm in director, so you're going to see a whole bunch of ghosted icons over here. If you're in creator, you still have groups as an option. You're just going to have less icons over here. So once you have your frame and your image into a group, now you can resize and reposition both of them as a group. You don't want to do them individually at this point. Once you have them in a group, now you can animate them as a single unit. So if I wanted this to slide from left to right, I would come into my animations tab on the first keyframe. I'd put it over here. Second keyframe, I'd put it over here. And now over the course of my slide, the frame and the picture moves together because we've put them in a group and we've animated the group. Of course, at this point, you can add more images to your layers if you want outside the group. So if I wanted a background, I can put another layer under the group like this, and it won't move with the group. So now my background will stay right there. My group will still move independently from the background like that. You can also add, so for groups, I'm giving you like a full lesson on groups right now. There are certain adjustments that you cannot add to a group. Outlines and drop shadows are two of them. That doesn't mean you can't have a drop shadow here. If I open the group, I can put a drop shadow on either one of these. I'm going to put it on the frame because my image is a little bit smaller, remember? So I'm going to add a drop shadow to my frame, make it a little bit bigger. And now as the group moves across, you can see that I still have that drop shadow that I added to my frame. Okay, so just to quickly recap, you'll add your frame and your photo, resize so that they look good together, add them both into a group, then animate your group if you want. You can add a background that will not be a part of the group or any other layer that you don't want to be part of a group. And if you want your group to have a shadow, add a shadow to one of the layers inside the group, because groups cannot have shadows, but you can kind of make it look like it does. And that is how you can add a frame to a photo, put them in a group so that you can animate them or resize them together, put a background or something behind the group that is not animated with it, and add a drop shadow. Thank you so much for watching and for allowing me to help you unleash your creativity.